कॉलेज पुरुलिया, ही हैज रिसीव्ड मेनी अवार्ड्स लाइक रिसिपियंट ऑफ नेशनल स्कॉलरशिप, ही सिक्योर सेकेंड रैंक इन बीएससी एग्जाम, इज द रिसिपियंट ऑफ বাহ্যজীবা দ্রোণাচার্য অ্যাওয়ার্ড অ্যান্ড পরিবারম দ্রোণাচার্য অ্যাওয়ার্ড, ইজ দ্য সায়েন্টিস্ট অফ দ্য ইয়ার 2019 অ্যাওয়ার্ড বাই ইন্টারন্যাশনাল একাডেমি অফ সায়েন্স অ্যান্ড রিসার্চ, হি ইজ অলসো অ্যাওয়ার্ডেড শিক্ষারত্ন ইন 2020 বাই দি হায়ার এডুকেশন ডিপার্টমেন্ট গভর্নমেন্ট অফ ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল, হি হ্যাজ মেম্বারশিপ in different professional bodies like Botanical Society of Bengal, Social Environmental and Biological Association, Indian Aerobiological Society, International Academy of Science and Research. He presented papers in 43 conference, seminars, symposia. He has delivered invited lectures, acted chairperson of 68 national international conference, seminar, workshop. His publication includes 19 abstracts of ISBN number, 6 book chapters and 6 are under press, 22 in journals and 2 under process. He has 2 ongoing research projects and he has completed one. Today, he will deliver a lecture titled Diversity in Pteridophytes in Purulia District. I welcome Professor Raha. So over to Dr. Raha. Please.
Thank you, sir. Respected delegates, the principal of Government General Degree College, Mohanpur, the organizers, especially my dear brother, Dr. Dwipayan Sinha, I am delivering a lecture on diversity of pteridophytes in Purulia district, particularly with the reference on ethnobotanical importance. I am sharing my slides and
Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay. So this is our university at Purulia. I welcome all of you to the Sridhar Ganabeesha University, which has started its from 2010, and Botany Department has initiated 4 years back from 2016 only. First of all, I want to highlight some of the characteristic features of this district regarding the soil, mainly residual soil, which is derived from the granites and mist is the characteristic soil type. And lateritic soils in the upland area is frequent, clay loam and clay interspersed with gravels is also another characteristic feature of this region. Soil is mainly acidic, ranging the pH ranges from 5.5 to 7.2. And soil erosion is high and mainly humus accumulated in the valley regions where the soil is much more fertile than the rest. Now, these ferns are of importance in the folklore and the plants successfully used in different systems of the medicines like Ayurveda, Yunani, homeopathy, and other systems of medicines. And the tribal people mainly use the rhizomes, fronds, and spores, and particularly the leaves for various to cure different ailments. And May published a review, detailed review, where he listed 105 medicinal ferns In a recent compilation by Singh reported 160 species of useful pteridophytes in India on the basis of its phytochemical, pharmacological, and ethnobotanical studies. And it's the antibacterial or antimicrobial property has also been established by different research works. Now, these other region, apparently the rest of the India knows Purulia as a drought prone region, but the hilly regions are much rich in biodiversity, different ferns, bryophytes, and half shrubs, medicinal plants grows here. In the above, you can see this is the Panchet or Panchakot Hill, which is a treasure box of different kinds of medicinal plants and orchids. This is Joychandi Hill. It harbors many pteridophytes, particularly two species are very much abundant here, which I am going to discuss later on. And this is Manbajar region, Jharna Gocha, and it is also densely forested. Here, the Ajodhya Hill ranges at the below, you can see, and this is a party, and these are different falls which runs through the hills. And these are the different documentation sites of different corners of Purulia. And particularly, this is the Purulia town. From a satellite map, you can see that this is the Ajodhya Hill from where most of the plant species were recorded. Here, it is the Hartan forest near Jhalda, where many species has been recorded. I'm sorry. And this is the Panchakot Hill or Panchet Hill. This is the Panchet Reservoir. This is Panchet Hill. Here, a small patch of forest you can see. This is called Raka forest. This is Bandwan and Manbajar region on the south, where these are the mainly collection sites or documentation sites. You can see in this map also, these are the Ajodhya Hilly region. This is Hartan forest. This is Panchakot Hill on the north. On the east, Rakab forest near Puncha, and here Jharna Gocha, Barabajar region. These are rich in different kinds of plant species. Total 35 species of wild pteridophytes belonging to 12 families under 24 genera were recorded. The dominant family was Pteridaceae with 10 species, followed by Salviniaceae, Ophioglossaceae, each with 4 species. Polypodiaceae, Thlipteridaceae, and Silaginaceae, each having 3 species, Lygodiaceae and Marsiliaceae, each represented by 2 species, and the rest of the families like Athariaceae, Equisetaceae, Glyciniaceae, and Isoidaceae are represented by only 1 species. And if we consider their habitat, then mostly we are getting terrestrial habitat. Among them, 54% is terrestrial, epiphytic 9%, aquatic 34%, and semi-aquatic 3% pteridophytes recorded from this region. Now, this is a list of pteridophytes, what I am going on later on, one by one. And this column indicates its nature. That means SA means semi-aquatic, T means terrestrial, A means aquatic, and so on. These are the different species what recorded from this region, and it is communicated for publication. Now, Adiantum incisum, where the leaf powder mixed with butter or ghee, it is mainly the reports, mainly the ethnobotanical informations collected from the Santhal and Birhot tribes of the hilly region. And also, they are very much cooperative, some not very much cooperative, but sometimes due to our creating a rapport with them, we have explored some of the information from them. It is used in cough, fever, and skin diseases, and leaf juice is also applied to check hair fall. This is the Adiantum incisum, and that is, it is common. The next one, which is Adiantum filipens, grows everywhere, where The decoction is used for chest pain and right.